Welcome, guys, to a new LEGO Star Wars pre-release set review. Today, we're looking at 75212, the Kessel Run Millennium Falcon, the first officially revealed LEGO model based on the ship in the upcoming film Solo, A Star Wars Story. The set will retail for $169.99, will consist of 1,414 pieces, and will include 4 minifigures and 1 droid. I've heard there's actually 5 minifigures and 2 droids, but we'll have to wait and see if that's the case. And that's where we'll begin, the minifigures. First off, since this is a Millennium Falcon set, you obviously get a Han Solo minifigure, and I love this version of him. It really captures Alden Ehrenreich's Han Solo look nicely, and I can't wait to add a sort of Alden Ehrenreich based on minifigure to my collection. He's one of my favorite actors these days. But back to the minifigures, I also love the familiar leg printing with a new color for the legs this time. It's never been on black before. The blaster and newer hairpiece are nice touches too, and the new torso printing sticks out as well with a very cool jacket design. Next, we have a new Chewbacca that has considerably more ruffles in his fur than his previous minifigure ancestors. It is definitely an interesting design. Now, I wasn't a big fan at first, but you know what? It's actually starting to grow on me. It looks true to the character, even though personally I'd like more of a slope on the head area. But the noteworthy designs are still there on all parts of the minifig, and now he's also got a pocket and 2 straps rather than 1. I do find it kind of odd that rather than giving him his bowcaster, LEGO gave him this long rifle instead. But maybe that has to do with the film. Personal interjections aside, though, this is a great Chewbacca minifigure. Next, we have our young Lando Calrissian figure, and this looks great. I love the new blue with the black accents cape, but the real eye catcher is the yellow torso with black straps running down the legs, and all of that looks awesome. The hairpiece also looks cool, but that new face print not only captures Donald Glover's likeness quite well, but Lando's character astoundingly well. Love that touch with the wink and the eyebrow, very much something Lando would do. And we're getting a new minifigure too, Kira, or Kira, however you pronounce it. She's got a nice new torso jacket print, plus a great face print and hairpiece. I can't tell if the hairpiece is new, but it looks slightly new to me, a little wider range on the bangs. Lastly, there's a new Kessel Operations droid. The printing's a bit chaotic to my eye, but I'm sure it's very faithful to the film, but I like the added footprinting. It looks very realistic, and it's not something you see very often with a LEGO minifigure. And it's probably an older droid, based on the red color. Now let's look at the new Millennium Falcon. Right away, the biggest change is the color. Now look, I love the classic colors, but the blue on white look really appeals to my eye. It also gives the ship more of an industrial look, like it's corporation property or something close to that. Secondly, the 2 fang-like endpoints of the ship have been also joined together. For some reason, I'm sure they'll explain later on in the film, but I like the united look of the ship, and as well as the added touches with the blue and bluish-gray-like pieces in the sloped headlight. There's also some smaller touches needing attention to. The docking ramp and landing gear return. The front dish has an updated construction, has been turned upward for some reason. Perhaps that gives it a greater sensory range. Who knows? But moving on, the cockpits also look like the classic cockpits we've seen before from Millennium Falcon. Now, the top and bottom weapons are an interesting aspect as well. This build is different, but the surrounding tile border on the top blaster set looks nice and is very pleasing to the eye and really sets the blaster apart from the rest of the model. But what's even more interesting is the top is a hatch construction. We've never seen that before in a Millennium Falcon LEGO model. It's usually just a 6x6 parabola dish used to enclose said area, but I like the new feature. I can't tell if the bottom is a hatch too, but I hope so. Overall, this is a great set with a great minifig selection. $169.99 seems like a bit much, but this set is very well worth it. I love the new Millennium Falcon. I can't wait to get one for myself, but what do you guys think? Is this a set that interests you? Let me know below. And until next time, God bless, and have a good day.